Hey, what's up guys, it's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you how to set up your funnel here in Kartra. Now don't confuse a funnel with a landing page, thank you page, sales page, that entire funnel. The funnel here in Kartra is more so a bird's eye view for you of the whole process so that you can map it out, play around with the numbers, and then see roughly how many leads or how many sales or how much traffic you need to make whatever goal you have work. So that's what a funnel is, and I'm going to show you how to set it up with all these pages and all these different components that we've set up here in Kartra. So the first thing we're going to do, of course, is click on funnels over here, and you will see the funnels tab and the simulations, right? So the first thing we need to do is set up a funnel, and then we're going to simulate it. That's the main point, is the simulation, so we can plug in the numbers and see what they look like. So the name of the funnel is going to be our affiliate marketing funnel. We can just say like that. Short description, everyone from the affiliate marketing guide to the Google Ads sales, right? So everything all the way from our funnel to from our landing page all the way to our sales page, our webinar page, so on and so forth. So this is going to be the builder. So you're going to have the builder. Once you publish it and save it, you'll be able to simulate it. You'll be able to see the analytics, the actual stats, zoom in, out, undo, redo. Multiple select allows you to select multiple elements. Okay. Then you have the assets, you have the actions, you have the traffic. So let's start with the traffic source. So what sort of traffic source do we want to send to our landing page, right? That's the first part. So you have generic ads, you have Bing ads, Google ads, you have the Facebook ads, right? So let's suppose the more common are, let's say, Google ads we have. So we're going to name it. So we're going to name it Google ads. Let's say we have Facebook ads are pretty common too. Facebook ads, and let's say we have Bing ads, right? And it's called Microsoft, actually, but we'll say Bing for those of us that have started a long time ago and are familiar with that. So this is our traffic source, okay? So let's go ahead and drag it a little bit more here on the left, more on the left, more on the left, and try to make it nice and even. So then you have the assets, right? So these are gonna be your pages, and then you have the actions. So whether it's a purchase or anything like that, so the assets, right? The first thing is we have our squeeze page. So we're gonna drag our squeeze page here, and it is an existing page. So it is this page right here. So we're just gonna select it, we'll click save. And so now we wanna drag all of these. We wanna say, okay, we're taking all these traffic sources to our landing page, right? And that looks a little bit messy. Let me see if we can make it look a little bit nicer. So I'm just gonna drag it via this way right here. And then this one I'm gonna drag via this way. It's all about the looks, right? For this, the looks here are important for this one, right? Because it's a bird's eye view. You wanna make it look nice and neat. So after people go on your page, what action do you want them to take? So you want them to submit the form. So we're gonna go ahead and submit the form over here. And it is an existing form. It is this form. We're going to hit save. And then again, we're going to connect the dots. So we're going to select this element. We're going to drag it right here. Okay. And we can zoom out a little bit and then we can move it around. So it might be pretty lengthy because we have a long funnel. And then from here, after they submit the form, where do they go? Well, they go on our thank you page. So we're going to go ahead and drag this thank you page here. And then we're going to select our thank you page, which we created. If all of this looks totally new to you, you have no idea what I'm talking about, I highly suggest you go through the previous videos or the previous sections in this course. And so you can see how to create all this, right? It's a very, very detailed, comprehensive course. I go over everything. So if you're at this stage, you should not be confused. So this is gonna be our thank you page for the guide, right? Not the purchase page. So we're gonna select that here. We're gonna hit save. And again, we're gonna connect it. Boom, okay, so let's just take a look at what we have so far. It looks nice and pretty, okay? I like it, I'm happy with it. So I'm gonna save progress for now. So what do we have so far? Well, we're gonna be sending traffic from these sources to our squeeze page that people will register on, and then they're gonna go on our thank you page, right? And so now on this thank you page, we want people to click that button, right? That's how they're gonna download that free guide. So that's what we wanna track as well. So we're gonna click button here, we're gonna add it here, and we're gonna say affiliate marketing guide. We're gonna hit save. Now, one thing to note is that this is an untraceable action. So this isn't something that you can actively track and trace, because this isn't like a purchase, a form registration, appointment, or a survey, okay? So this is just for our reference. So we're gonna drag it here. Now, after they download the guide, they get an email, or there's gonna be a little link below the button that's gonna take them to our sales page, right? So we're gonna drag the sales page now. And the sales page we have is this Google Ads course main sales page. We're going to hit next, and we're going to connect the two. And so they're going to land on this page. And then from this page, there are different options, right? So they can either land on they can either create an appointment, they can either create a survey or a webinar. They can land on the survey, or they can do a webinar registration. So if we go to actions here, we can set appointment here. We have an existing appointment here, the consultation. That's what they could do on the sales page. They could purchase the product, an existing product that we have. This Google Ads one at any price point. It doesn't matter as long as they purchase it. Or they could set, they could do the survey, right? So we have that existing survey. And we can select the survey. So they have all these options that from this sales page, this is where they can go, okay? So we're just gonna connect them, and we're gonna do this. So people have all these different options. Now, after they purchase specifically, they're gonna land on the thank you page after they purchase, which we already have, which is the thank you purchase page. We're gonna select that, and we're gonna drag it a little bit more so, like that. No, there you go. So it's nice and neat, right? Drag like so, and that looks pretty good so far. So they can either book a consultation, they can purchase the course, they can fill in the survey. Now there is one more thing here that is not under actions, and that is the webinar, right? So the webinar registration. So for that one, we're gonna select assets, and we're gonna select webinar registration right here. And there's also other things here, such as membership portal, but the membership portal would be the Google Ads course. So that's fine, so they're gonna go there. And then, yeah, if you have upsells or downsells, you would add them here as well, but we don't in this case. So we are going to select this membership here, and we're gonna add it here. And then we do have a webinar that we've already created. So for this option, your webinar page will not show up here, just existing pages will show up here. So we didn't create a special webinar page, right? It's just the webinar registration. So what we can do instead is come over here and say webinar registration, and then we can pull up our webinar page. And so this is just for our reference, right? So we can come in here and drag this, oops, let's drag it over here. There you go, right? So these are the different options people have when they land on our sales page. So that I think is pretty much it as far as options we have. If you go to traffic, you can take a look at all the different traffic options you have, all the different actions. You have the true action as well. So if somebody buys your Google Ads course, for example, buys, then they'll be taken to this page. If somebody doesn't buy, then they'll be sent this email, something like that. So that's how that option works. I'm gonna remove that. But that looks pretty good for now. That looks pretty accurate as to our entire funnel that we have set up together here in Kartra over the course of this course. So I'm gonna click Save Progress, and then we're gonna come in here, we're gonna click Save and Exit, and then we need to actually go into simulations, right? So now that that's done, now we can click on simulations. And we're gonna click on simulation here. We have to create it now. So our business, right? So like affiliate marketing course sales maybe, or let's just say sales, because we have many different ways of getting the sale. And then we'll click on affiliate marketing funnel, click on create. And now this is the whole point of the funnel, right? Is to be able to plug in these numbers and then see all these details here. And the way we do that is we select each option, anyone we want. So we select simulation, and then you select a specific option, click on top of it, and then say, let's say from Google, we get 30 visitors per day, cost per click of, let's say, 50 cents, okay? So now it's gonna tell you, you know, how much you spent, and then how much we made. So total traffic cost, I believe this would be then, oh yeah, well, it tells you per month. And then for Facebook ads, I'm gonna select that, click on traffic. Let's suppose we're sending 50 visitors a day at an average of, let's say, 40 cents, right? And then Microsoft ads is gonna be a little cheaper, but also less traffic. So 20 per day, but 20 cents. Okay, so then here we have 100 people visiting this page, if you do the math, per day, right? Because that's what we said is daily. Now, how many form submits are there? So this funnels feature is currently under development. So you're not able to come in here and edit your signups, but you should be able to. So I've contacted support. This is something that I've reached out to them about, and they tell me that they're working on it. So generally what you would do is you would be able to click on this and enter how many people sign up. And then you would come over here, for example, to your sales, and you would say how many people have purchased your course. You'd be able to enter the sales, enter the percentage, right, an average conversion rate, and then you'll be able to see all the numbers here. And then you can do the same thing for all of these, right? So out of all these people, out of all these 100 people that enter your site, let's say 50 sign up. So you'll have 50 here, you'll have 50 here, and then how many people click on the button? Let's say 30. So you'll be able to click here and you should be able to select it again. So that's one of the bugs, one of the issues here that they're working on. But once this works, this is how this is gonna work. You'll be able to click on here and then you'll be able to set how many people clicked on the button. And then out of those people that clicked, how many people, so all the people that clicked will land on this page. And then from here, how many people normally would book your appointments? How many people would book your course? How many people would go to your survey? Things like that, right? And then you're gonna see all the numbers here. So at a glance, you'll be able to see. It's very, very, very cool, useful feature because you'll be able to see everything right over here, how much your cost is, what your sales are, right? So you'll be able to know exactly how many people you need in your funnel with an average sales rate of, let's say, I don't know, 2%. Of an average sales rate, how many people do you need? How much traffic do you need to break even? That's what this is gonna be like. And then if you go to analytics, you're actually gonna see real data. So you'll be able to actually see what is going on in reality, right? So you have the simulation versus reality. So this simulation is, again, like I said, a little bit under construction. I have contacted support several times about this and they are working on it. But once it does, that's how this works. That's how you set up this funnel. You'll be able to click on every individual element and specify, hey, how many people would normally sign up for an appointment via this page, right? And then you'll be able to see everything here. So that is it. That is how you create this funnel. I think it's pretty neat, pretty cool. Allows you to see everything at a glance. And if you guys haven't taken advantage of Kartra yet, I do invite you to use my affiliate link at go.ivanmehta.com/Kartra because I give you an exclusive offer, a 30-day free trial, and 20% off on your first payment. So a cool deal that you can't find by just going to Kartra.com. So that is pretty much it for this funnel video here. In the next section, I want to show you just the remaining few things here with Kartra because otherwise we've covered absolutely everything there is to do with Kartra. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.